you have been thinking about applying for scholarships because you're a senior or a junior in high school. In this video, I give you 5 tips on how to prepare to apply for scholarships. Hello, I'm Rebecca M Carroll, and this is the College Light Bulb, where we illuminate your path to college. On this channel, we actually interview people in different career paths you might be exploring. We call that our career series. We also give tips and strategies on applying for college, applying for scholarships, earning money for college, getting ready for your school selections, all kinds of things that have to do with college. So if you're new, please consider subscribing to our channel. So let's begin. The first tip is a resume. It is so important that you have a resume. It's good to have a resume that highlights your education. For example, list your high school, where it's located. List some of your academic courses, especially those in the field that you're looking at that they would be most important for them. Also, you need to list your leadership, and I would actually categorize it as leadership. It is so important. Remember that things like being first chair in your orchestra, being a captain of your team, those are all things that count for leadership. So it's important for you to remember that. And sometimes it's helpful to ask your parents because they oftentimes will remind you of what you had done during the high school years. So you can always start from the end of junior high, end of eighth grade, through high school. That is what your resume should be, unless you did something unbelievably phenomenal, say in fifth grade that got you in the news, that was just, you know, crazy viral. That is the only time that you put anything below ninth grade. The next thing I want to talk to you about are transcripts. So tip number 2, transcripts. Many students have never requested their transcript. It is so important for you to know what's on your transcript, and many, many scholarships ask for a copy of your transcript. Please be careful to make sure if your school puts your social security number on it that you black that out, and if it has too much information about you other than your name and the state you're from. So it's very, very important to have that. It's important that you have and know what your GPA is on a 4.0 scale as well as a weighted scale. Don't panic if your school does not weight your GPA. Colleges are very interested in students who try their hardest and take the most rigorous program they can, whether or not your school has AP or dual enrollment or a weighted GPA. So that is something you don't even need to worry about. Tip number 3. It is important because if you're going to treat this like a job, which you should, you need a separate email just for scholarships because you will be inundated once you get into these programs. So a couple of really great apps that I like for scholarships are RaiseMe, Scholarship Owl, Niche, as well as Scholly. You can find more scholarship searches on College Board. You can find a ton of places to go for scholarships. It is important, though, like I said, make a Gmail that everybody can get into, including your parents, because the search process can be extensive. And if you have more people helping you with the search, that's really helpful. Now, when I say your parents helping you, I don't mean that they're writing the scholarship essays or anything like that for you, but that they are helping to look for scholarships that you actually qualify for. Speaking of qualifying, tip number 4, you need to know what your estimated family contribution is. And the greatest way to find that out before you fill out that FAFSA senior year is to actually find a really dynamite tool that will help you. And we happen to have that. It is important that you do this because it will allow you to know if you qualify as need, or you might know that you qualify for partial need. Many of the scholarships that you will be looking at, that will be their highest priority that they're looking for. Is this student someone who is considered, according to the federal government, is this someone who qualifies for financial aid? So please have your parents go into that free tool that we provide. It gives you a wonderful report. The link is below. It's thecoachingeducator.com/EFC. Very convenient. It will be very helpful. It actually looks at state schools as well as private schools. Tip number 5, and this is a big one, schedule time weekly. I encourage people to start working on it. If you're a junior, start looking for scholarships and lining them up over the summer. Plant yourself weekly. Put a time in your schedule. Treat it like a job. And then if you're a senior, really start going at it August, because there are some major scholarships that are open and due by October 1st. So the question we have for you is, what is the most challenging thing that you are experiencing while applying for scholarships? Whether you're noticing that your student has a challenge, please put it in the comments, or you are the student. If you have any tips for other people, please add them. But we will be getting back to you. We'll respond and help you out any way we can. Another thing to note is that this is part of our series. So we're doing a scholarship series. So again, like us, share, and please subscribe to our channel and help us get this information out to as many people as possible. We also have a downloadable form for you with frequently asked questions as well that will help you before you fill out that free EFC. So go down below and get that link and you can download it, or you can go to thecoachingeducator.com/free forms. And that will help you. It'll help you before you do that tool. And it will help you to know what you're actually going to need before you fill out the FAFSA. Again, I'm Rebecca M. Carroll. Please like and share us, and see you in the next series.